Wonka Doodles at Macduff's Chocolate Factory. A script, Willy Macduff. Introduction, an audience interaction, before entering the Garden of Enchantment.
Scene, a whimsical, brightly lit stage that hints at the magic of the Garden of Enchantment beyond. Willy Macduff, a character of eccentric charm and wit, stands before the curtain that separates the mundane from the magical. The audience is buzzing with anticipation.
Ladies, gentlemen, and esteemed guests of all ages, welcome. I am Willy Macduff, your humble guide on this journey to the extraordinary, the spectacular, the downright magical Garden of Enchantment.
Audience laughs.
Ah, I see we have enthusiasts among us. But before we proceed, a few formalities. Well, not so formal if I have anything to say about it.
He strides downstage, closer to the audience, with a mischievous twinkle in his eye.
You see, the Garden of Enchantment isn't just any garden. Oh, no. It's a place where the trees whisper secrets of old, the flowers sing in harmony, and the stones, well, they mostly just sit there, but they do it enchantingly.
Audience laughs.
Now I must ask, who among you has brought their sense of wonder? Show of hands, please.
Audience members raise their hands, some enthusiastically, others more timidly.
Splendid. And who has packed an extra pair of socks? You know, in case the first pair gets knocked off by sheer amazement?
Audience laughs again. A few hands remain raised.
Ah, we have some well-prepared adventurers. Excellent. Your journey into the garden will be one of awe, of laughter, and perhaps a mild case of bewilderment. But fear not, for I, Willy Macduff, have traversed its paths many a time and have only gotten lost thrice.
Audience chuckles, enjoying Macduff's self-deprecating humor.
Now a crucial question. Does anyone here speak fluent squirrel? No? Shame, they're the best conversationalists in the garden. But worry not, for I am a certified interpreter of squirrel, duck, and on special occasions, bashful tulip.
Audience is visibly amused. Some are leaning in, fully engaged in Macduff's charismatic presence.
Before we embark, I must warn you, the garden has a way of enhancing one's emotions. So if you find yourself inexplicably joyful or suddenly bursting into song, embrace it. It's all part of the enchantment.
He starts to walk back towards the stage.
And now, my dear friends, are you ready to leave the mundane behind and step into a world where the impossible becomes possible, where every turn brings a new wonder, and where the only limit is your imagination?
The audience responds with cheers and applause.
Then, without further ado, let us proceed. But remember, keep your belongings close, your wits about you, and your socks well secured. To the Garden of Enchantment we go.
Willy Macduff leads the audience with a dramatic gesture towards the curtain, which slowly begins to open, revealing the first glimpses of the Garden of Enchantment as lights and sounds from the magical realm spill into the auditorium, ending the scene on a high note of anticipation and excitement.
In the Garden of Enchantment with Willy Macduff and the Wonka Doodles.
Scene, the stage transforms into a vibrant, mystical Garden of Enchantment, filled with oversized, colorful flowers, twinkling lights, and mysterious pathways. Willy Macduff, with his distinct attire and a sparkle in his eyes, is joined by the playful Wonkadoodles, each holding baskets brimming with an assortment of whimsical sweets.
Ah, welcome. Welcome to the heart of the Garden of Enchantment, a place where wonders never cease, and the sweets,
he gestures towards the Wonkadoodles,
are as enchanting as the surroundings.
The Wonkadoodles dance around, offering sweets to the audience members who have followed them onto the stage, transformed into the garden for this immersive experience. Wonkadoodle 1, tripping over a pretend stone, sweets flying everywhere.
Oops, it seems even the stones want a taste of our treats.
Audience laughs as Wonkadoodle 2 helps gather the sweets, turning the mishap into a playful act.
Careful there. Our garden stones are known to be quite the sweet tooths. Now, dear guests, feel free to explore, but beware of the giggle grass. It's been known to induce spontaneous laughter.
Audience members are encouraged to move around and interact with the set pieces, including the giggle grass, which, when stepped on, triggers hidden speakers to play laughter sounds. Wonkadoodle 2, handing out a peculiarly shaped candy.
Try this. It's our latest creation, the Whizbang Whirligig. Just be sure you're not standing upside down when you eat it, or you might find yourself floating.
And if anyone encounters our talking tulips, do pay them a compliment. They've been a bit wilting lately, and a kind word goes a long way in this garden.
Audience members are encouraged to move around and interact with the set pieces, including the giggle grass, which, when stepped on, triggers hidden speakers to play laughter sounds.
Oh, and if you see a butterfly, whisper your sweetest dream to it. There are official secret keepers and dream carriers of the garden.
Now I must ask, has anyone seen the elusive bubble bloom? It's a rare flower that blooms just once every blue moon and fills the air with shimmering bubbles.
The stage crew discreetly activates bubble machines, filling the area with bubbles, causing excitement and wonder among the audience.
Quick! Each bubble holds a whisper of enchantment. Catch one and make a wish.
As the bubble-catching frenzy continues.
Remember, in the Garden of Enchantment, every moment is a chance for magic. Every corner hides a story, and every bubble.
Willy McDuff catches a bubble.
Holds a dream.
He opens his hand, and the bubble gently pops, releasing a small, twinkling light that ascends into the rafters, leaving the audience in awe.
My dear friends, take this time to explore, to laugh, and to dream. For in this garden, the magic is real, and the possibilities are endless. And who knows? The next wonder you encounter may just be around the next bend.
Scene ends with the audience fully immersed in the interactive, magical experience, laughter and joy filling the air as Willy McDuff and the Wonkadoodles continue to engage and delight with their enchanting antics and treats.
Scene before entry into the dark and mysterious twilight tunnel.
Scene, the vibrant colors and whimsical laughter of the Garden of Enchantment gradually give way to a more subdued atmosphere. The path narrows, and the light dims, leading to the entrance of the twilight tunnel. Willy McDuff, with a lantern in hand, gathers the audience at the threshold, where shadows dance and an air of mystery envelopes the space. The Wonkadoodles huddle close, their usual mirth replaced by an eager anticipation mixed with a hint of apprehension. Willy McDuff, in a hushed tone, drawing the audience closer.
Brave explorers, our journey through the Garden of Enchantment has brought us to a most curious threshold, the entrance to the Twilight Tunnel.
The audience's chatter quiets down, their attention captured by the change in Willy's tone and the intriguing darkness ahead.
Beyond this point lies a realm of shadows and whispers, a place where the mysteries of the night come alive. But fear not, for though the path may be veiled in darkness, it is also speckled with the light of 1,000 twilight stars.
Wonkadoodle One clutches a small, glowing orb, offering a visual representation of the twilight stars Willy mentioned.
These orbs are the captured essence of twilight itself. They will guide us when the stars above are shy.
Indeed, my friend. And as we step into the shadows, remember, it is in the darkness that the light shines brightest. So I ask you, are you ready to embrace the unknown and discover the secrets that lie within?
The audience murmurs affirmatively, a mix of excitement and nervous anticipation in the air.
Fear not, for you are not alone. Together we shall traverse the twists and turns of the twilight tunnel, and who knows what wonders we might uncover.
Willy turns to the Wonkadoodles, who are now distributing the glowing orbs to the audience members.
These orbs are not only our light, but our promise to each other, that no matter how dark the path, we will find our way through together.
Wonkadoodle 2, looking slightly more courageous, steps forward.
And remember, in the twilight tunnel, it's not just about finding the light. It's about finding the courage within ourselves to face the dark and emerge stronger on the other side.
So with hearts brave and spirits bold, let us step into the twilight tunnel where adventure awaits at every shadow's edge. After all, the greatest treasures are often hidden in the darkest places.
Willy leads the way into the tunnel, with the audience following closely behind, their glowing orbs illuminating the path as they venture into the unknown, leaving the world of light and laughter behind for a journey filled with mystery and discovery. Scene ends as the group disappears into the mouth of the twilight tunnel, the light from their orbs casting a soft glow that fades into the encompassing darkness, setting the stage for an adventure unlike any other.
Scene in the twilight tunnel with Willy McDuff, the unknown, and the anti-graffiti gobstopper.
Scene, deep within the serpentine pathways of the twilight tunnel, the atmosphere grows tense as Willy McDuff gathers the audience in a semicircle. His face is illuminated by the flickering light of his lantern, casting long shadows on the walls. The group's laughter and whispers fade as Willy begins to speak in a grave tone.
My dear adventurers, We stand on the precipice of a discovery most wondrous and perilous. For within these ancient walls lurks a tale not yet told, of an evil chocolate maker known only as the unknown.
The audience leans in, captivated by Willy's words.
This fiendish foe has long coveted one of my most cherished creations, the anti-graffiti gobstopper. A marvel of confectionery science designed to aid, oh, not just any soul, but the tireless guardians of cleanliness, our beloved mums. And yes, dads too, but especially mums, from the endless scourge of dirty socks strewn about by youthful adventurers.
A murmur of amusement and agreement ripples through the audience. Willy McDuff, suddenly freezing mid-sentence, his expression locked in shocked silence envelopes the group, the tension palpable. Then, from the shadows, a figure emerges, cloaked in mystery and malice, the unknown. The unknown, with a voice both smooth and sinister.
Willy McDuff and his band of intrepid explorers. You have something I desire, and with your unwitting aid, it shall be mine. The anti-graffiti gobstopper will no longer clean your worlds. It will turn them to chaos at my command.
The audience gasps, some shifting nervously, as the unknown scans the crowd, his gaze landing on a chosen audience member.
You there? Yes, you will assist me in acquiring this precious sweet. Together, we shall rewrite the rules of cleanliness and order.
As the unknown extends a hand towards the audience member, the room suddenly brightens, and Willy McDuff unfreezes, shaking his head as if disoriented.
What happened? Did anyone else feel a chill? You all look as if you've seen a ghost. Or perhaps you're just feeling a bit whitey.
Laughter breaks the tension, as Willy reassures the audience with a wink and a smile, subtly dismissing the ominous threat of the unknown as nothing more than a momentary illusion.
Fear not, my friends, for the power of imagination and good cheer can dispel even the darkest of shadows. Now let us continue our journey with hearts light and spirits undimmed.
Transition to the bubble and lemonade room.
Speaking of light spirits, I find myself quite parched after our unexpected adventure. But fortune smiles upon us, for just beyond this door lies a room filled with refreshments most delightful, the bubble and lemonade room.
With a flourish, Willy opens a previously unnoticed door, revealing a room where the air sparkles with floating bubbles and rivers of sparkling lemonade flow freely.
Here, my dear guests, you may quench your thirst with lemonade that fizzes and dances on the tongue and chase bubbles that burst with flavors unimaginable. A toast to adventures shared and friendships forged in the heart of the unknown.
The audience, now relieved and rejuvenated by the whimsical turn of events, follows Willy into the bubble and lemonade room, laughter and chatter filling the air once more as they immerse themselves in the joyous, bubbly wonderland.
Scene: The Imagination Lab and McDuff TV.
Scene: Inside the vibrant bubble and lemonade room, the guests' laughter and enjoyment fill the air as they sip on the fizzy, magical drinks. Their attention is soon drawn to a mysterious door marked Imagination Lab. Keep out. Willy McDuff, with a mischievous glint in his eye, gathers the guests around the forbidden entrance.
Ah, my curious friends, behind this door lies the heart of our confectionery wonders, the Imagination Lab. A place where the impossible becomes possible, and the peculiar becomes delightful.
The audience leans in, eager to hear more about the mystical lab.
Within these walls, we've concocted creations beyond your wildest dreams. McDuff TV, for instance, where you can watch your favorite flavors come to life right before your eyes.
A murmur of intrigue spreads through the crowd.
And let's not forget our secret inventions, the soup-flavored jelly beans designed to keep the wee ones clean, hot and spicy beans that attract the birds. That's a story for another day, or perhaps a question for your parents.
The audience chuckles, appreciating the playful innuendo.
Ah, and my favorite, the boogerberry bean, freshly made from Grandpa's old crusty hanky. A taste that's, well, let's just say, uniquely exquisite.
The guests exchange amused and slightly apprehensive glances.
And of course, the pièce de résistance, the anti-graffiti gobstopper. Not only a marvel in keeping children's rooms clean, but a testament to the wonders of imagination and innovation.
The door slowly swings open, revealing a glimpse of the lab's interior, flashes of color, bubbling concoctions, and strange machinery.
Scene: Trying the strange sweets.
Now, who among you dares to taste the fruits of our imagination? Step right up and prepare for a flavor adventure unlike any other.
The guests eagerly approach a table laden with the described sweets, each picking their choice with a mix of excitement and trepidation. Guest 1, trying the soup-flavored jelly bean.
It's like dinner in a dessert. Astonishing.
Guest 2, braving the boogerberry bean.
Oh, wow. It's oddly gorgeous. How is that possible?
Laughter and surprised exclamations fill the room as the guests indulge in the whimsical treats.
Scene, Macduff TV camera.
As the tasting continues, Willy Macduff gestures towards an old-fashioned camera with a signed Macduff TV on it.
And now for a bit of fun, let's capture your expressions for Macduff TV, the only channel where every reaction is a flavor sensation.
The camera lights up, and Willy directs the guests to react to the flavors they're experiencing. Their expressions of delight, surprise, and bemusement are broadcast on a vintage television set in the corner, providing a hilarious and heartwarming spectacle.
Look at those marvelous expressions. Each face tells a story, a testament to the boundless realms of taste and imagination. Remember, in the Imagination Lab, every discovery is a step towards joy, and every flavor tells a tale.
Scene ends with the guests gathered around the television, watching themselves and laughing together, united in a shared experience of wonder and discovery. Willy Macduff watches over them, a satisfied smile on his face, knowing that the spirit of adventure and imagination has been kindled in their hearts.
Scene, Willy vs. the Unknown, the Anti-Graffiti Gobstopper Showdown.
Scene, the excitement within the Imagination Lab reaches a crescendo as the guests gather around for an unprecedented spectacle. The lights dim, and a spotlight illuminates Willy Macduff standing at one end of the room, holding the last anti-graffiti gobstopper in his hand. Opposite him, shrouded in darkness, emerges the unknown, with a device that emits a sinister glow. The air crackles with anticipation. Willy Macduff, holding up the gobstopper.
Behold, the culmination of imagination and ingenuity, the anti-graffiti gobstopper. A sweet so powerful, it can make any room sparkle without lifting a finger. But it seems our friend, the unknown, would rather use it for less tidy purposes.
That's right, Macduff. Imagine the chaos, the absolute power of turning tidiness into turmoil. Hand it over, and I might consider sparing your precious lab.
The audience gasps, tension mounting as the two adversaries stand ready.
In the spirit of imagination and the pursuit of joy, I cannot let that happen. If it's a showdown you want, it's a showdown you'll get.
Suddenly, the room transforms into a battlefield of lights and lasers. Willy uses a device resembling a futuristic remote, activating traps and illusions around the lab to thwart the unknown's advances.
You think these parlor tricks will stop me? I've come too far to be foiled now.
He retaliates with his own device, shooting beams of light towards Willy, who skillfully evades them, using the lab's inventions as shields and counters.
It's not about stopping you with tricks, but with creativity. For every dark intention, there's a light of innovation ready to shine through.
Willy activates a machine that releases a dazzling display of holographic images, momentarily disorienting the unknown. Seizing the opportunity, Willy sets the anti-graffiti gobstopper into a contraption that amplifies its cleanup capabilities, sending a wave of sparkling cleanliness towards the unknown, neutralizing his device and rendering him harmless. The unknown, stumbling, caught in the sparkling wave.
No. My plans thwarted by tidiness.
The guests cheer as the unknown is gently swept up by a robotic vacuum, humorously ending the confrontation.
And so, my friends, we see that even in the face of darkness, the light of imagination, joy, and a bit of clever cleaning can prevail. Let us remember, the greatest adventures and the most enduring victories are those we achieve together.
The room lights up, returning to its vibrant state, as Willy offers a bow, the anti-graffiti gobstopper safely in hand. The guests erupt into applause, celebrating the triumph of creativity and courage over chaos. Scene ends with Willy Macduff and the guests reveling in the success of their imaginative endeavor, reinforcing the power of unity and the endless possibilities that lie within the realms of imagination and innovation.